My dear beautiful humans, there's something I'd like to share with respect to my upcoming Sikh Genocide 1984 series. Some details may make us feel uncomfortable. As much as we say ignorance is bliss, to avoid the feelings that weigh our hearts down, it's in those very tiny moments that we decide to comply with injustice or not. For when we intentionally turn a blind eye is when we comply with injustice. Very often people call these emotions negative, but it's these very emotions that create a change over time. This change can be positive if we choose to make it positive. So feeling these emotions is not wrong, and these emotions themselves are not negative, but we have the power to channel it the right way to do the right thing. So if a right change is created, then how can that emotion be only negative or wrong? I urge you to reflect on this and not be afraid to feel, not be afraid to be uncomfortable, and not be afraid to be bothered. For when we are bothered is when we know we care, and when we care is when we know our heart is in the right place. We can be allies to the oppressed even if we haven't been in their shoes. We can be allies to those who stood up for our ancestors or us in times of trouble, or even if they didn't. We can also choose to not be allies, but it's our responsibility to be informed of both sides. I wish for us to have the courage to see beyond what's shown to us and to critically analyze and choose a side on our own terms. Being an ally does not mean that we back people up even if they're wrong. Calling them out for their mistakes respectfully is also love, and it's the fair thing to do. I hope from the bottom of my heart that we can look at each other beyond our religion, language, skin color, and ethnicities, and keep reminding ourselves that we have more in common than we have different. We're all one, and we're stronger together.